You're listening to Eat, Play, Sex with Dr. Kat, the place to uplevel that sexy life of yours with expert talk on sex, love, and nutrition.
Yeah. There's a book, one of my favorite books that explained a lot of the nuances of relationships was Polysecure. Are you familiar with that one? I just got my chance to read it yet. Oh my God, I'm obsessed. I've read it at least like, maybe like once, but it's really great. I keep going back to it. And there's a chart inside of there that describes different manifestations of relationships and of non-traditional relationships. And from a spectrum of sexual exclusivity and low sexual exclusivity, and then low emotional exclusivity to high emotional exclusivity. So it's like a quadrant. And along those, there's all these different manifestations of it that I didn't even think about. You know, there's monogamy, there's monogamish, there's polyfidelity, there's hierarchical polyamory, polyintimates, solo polyamory, relationship anarchy. It was like, I was like, oh my God, this is the holy grail of like everything that we can, you know, it almost gives permission of, like you said, to design your own relationships. It's like Build-A-Bear. You get to pick this and you get to pick this.
Yes. And I think people in open relationships tend to do that anyway. And for years, I've always, anytime I'm working with couples, I always try to tell them and get that thought in their whether they're choosing monogamy or not, but that thought process of your relationship does not like have to look like anyone else's. Doesn't look like your parents, your siblings, or your friends, or the people you went to school with. Like you get to design this so that it actually works for the people involved in the relationship.
Yeah, which it almost makes it, I feel like we're a lot more motivated to make something work when it's ours. You know, these are the things that are most in line with us versus just adopting a message from somebody else or from culture or from family.
Yeah. And so many people have gotten that message that they have to adopt what they've been given from family and culture and society, and don't even realize that they really can design it how they want it. As long as it's working for the people involved, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And it's a freeing thought when you can really wrap your head around it and be like, this doesn't have to look like my parents' marriage. You know, especially when you think about whatever you learned growing up about your parents' marriage that you noticed was not very healthy or was rather dysfunctional. You know, I don't have to adopt that part.
Yes.
How freeing that can be.
Yeah. Freeing and scary too, I can imagine.
Well, yeah. It can be a bit scary. Yeah. Because I think people attach to those things because it gives them that sense that they know what to do. They know what to expect. And you take that away, they feel like they have no safety net. Which is why I think people cling to that so much, even when they're unhappy with it.
Yeah. So like security based on the structure, the relationship structure, or the relationship identity versus the security that's created from your own sense of self.
Right. Exactly.
That once you're in a relationship where you don't have like these preset ideas of what it looks like, it's you're faced with, oh my God, can I find security in myself? Even if, you know, however this ends up unfolding.
Exactly. Yeah. And that is very terrifying for many people.
Lovers, thank you again for tuning in. If you enjoyed the show, hit subscribe and head over to eatplaysex.com to connect with me and grab my sexy guides. Because my goal here is to get you to eat, play, and sex better. So you can improve your sex life, which will improve every aspect of your life. Until next time, keep it sexy.